Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look of all things solar. In this video, we're going to talk about all the different types of electric meters. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry. And before we begin, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you'll be notified when we make more content just like this.
You know, Larry, it seems so confusing when you go solar. There's all these different types of electric meters for your solar, electric meters for your facility. Help us make sense of the different types of meters that are out there.
Well, first of all, there's two categories that you mentioned. One is the existing meter at your facility, which is for your utility, measures the electricity flow into your building. And then when you install solar, it also measures the flow out of your building from the solar array. The second category is the meters that come along with your solar array. There's typically a PV meter that measures all the output from your solar array at one location. And then in addition, there's something that we call a consumption meter, which can be attached to your service and can actually measure the power that you use through your meter or through PV for your actual loads.
Great. So let's talk first about your utility meters, your pass-through meter or your CT meter. What's the difference between them and how do they work?
Yeah, so the pass-through meter, the electricity actually passes right through the meter. You have your wires coming in to the top of the meter and landing on the top, wires going out to the bottom, and the electricity actually flows right through that meter. For a CT meter, you put what's called a CT, you clamp it around your wires, and it measures the electricity flow through the wires in that way.
Okay, Larry, now let's talk about the meters that go along with going solar.
Yeah, so there's two primary meters that we can typically talk about there. One is your PV meter, which measures all the production of your solar array. Then the other is a consumption meter, which measures the power that you use in your facility, whether you're getting it from the utility or from the solar array itself.
So Larry, what would determine whether I'd use a CT meter or a pass-through meter?
Yeah, so there's a couple factors there. One is the manufacturer of the product that you're using. SolarEdge, for example, has a meter integrated in the inverter that's a CT meter that you can just connect up and you're ready to go. Another consideration is space. CT meters typically take less space and they often also take less installation time as well.
So in summary, there's a variety of different meters. There are the utility meters, which can either be a pass-through meter or a CT meter. And then on the solar side, you have your PV meter, which measures just the production coming from your solar, or a consumption meter, which measures the amount of energy coming from your solar that may be used before it even goes through the PV meter. So that gives you a good indication of exactly how much energy the solar is producing, regardless of whether it gets used or gets sent through the meter.